All right. Anyway, so this is the one that was written about John Lennon. But like I say, Elton John did all the music, and Bernie Taupin was the one that was a genius with words. So anyway, ooh. Bernie Taupin, or Taupin, whatever way you want to pronounce it.
Okay, sounds familiar.
Yeah, he's the one that wrote all the words for Elton John's tunes. I don't know if he still does or not. I don't, because of course in Lion King it wasn't him; it was Tim Rice who wrote the words on that one. But anyway, here we go, Elton John.
What happened here as the New York sunset disappeared? I found an empty garden among the flagstones there. Ooh, who lived here? He must have been a gardener that cared a lot, who weeded out the tears and grew a good crop. Now it all looks strange. It's funny how one insect can damage so much grain. And what's it for, this little empty garden by the brownstone door, and in the cracks along the sidewalk, nothing grows no more. Ooh, lived here, he must have been a gardener that cared a lot, weeded out the tears and grew a good crop. And we are so amazed, we're crippled and we're dazed. A gardener like that one, no one can replace. He'd have said that roots grow stronger if only he could hear. Ooh, lived there, he must have been a gardener that cared a lot, who weeded out the tears and grew a good crop. Now we pray for rain, and with every drop I'm
Oh, about the bitches back.
Well, the bitches back, yeah. I was telling them that back in the old days, we played that a couple of times at wedding receptions, and we got in trouble. I remember one time a guy come up and said, "You got the bitches back?" And, "Oh, yeah, sure, we got a good song. They were funny. We had a lot of fun." He says, "Dedicated to my wife." Well, you know, dumb us. Had a couple of beers and did it, and we got another beer right in the face. Oh, if I remember correctly, she got a little hot on that one.
That was back in the old days when you
That was back in the old days when you had fun.
Yeah, we had fun. I just want to give you a little trivia here as far as Elton John goes, and John Lennon, because he did. Bridges and Signs album, I think it was, or what? Not Bridges and Signs. That's Robin Trower. But anyway, he did one of the albums.
You know about Robin Trower?
Yeah. Do I know about him?
Yeah.
Not a whole lot. Why?
Oh, I
know I liked his music.
There was a guy that worked in the parking lot at Home Depot. I forgot his name now, but he liked Robin Trower, so I got him some music and downloaded and made him some CDs. That's the first time I'd heard about it. Then
really?
Now every so often I see new stuff
by Robin
becoming available by Robin Trower. And I'm going, oh, geez.
Yeah, I like Robin Trower.
Anyways, go ahead with your trivia.
Anyway, so Elton John did an album with John Lennon when he kind of did his little separation time from Yoko Ono when they were having their, I don't know, fight or
whatever they did, yeah.
And he had a number one song with Elton John. Do you know what that song was?
Yeah, I just read it here, but off the top of my head, I can't remember what it was now.
Yeah,
Don't
God,
Go Breaking My Heart. That was Kiki D.
Yeah, number one song he did with John Lennon, and it was John Lennon's album, was Whatever Gets You Through the Night.
Yeah, okay.
Elton John was singing the background
mm-hmm.
in there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that was
can hear it.
I think that was like John Lennon's biggest number one hit, too, on his own.
On his own? Could be.
Yeah. But I could be wrong now. I don't know.
Does that mean I get the book out again?
I guess, yeah.
Okay.
I could be wrong.
That's under L, right?
Yeah, I didn't think I was ever wrong, but I guess I am once in a while.
Well, we decided that you were probably thinking top 10
songs.
Yeah,
top 10 songs, yeah.
Because he had top 10 songs all the way straight through his career every year. I think John Lennon, Wes Julian Lennon, I'm sorry. That's his kid. Let's get Dad here. John Lennon, his biggest hit was Imagine.
Oh, okay.
Just Like Starting Over. Whatever Gets You Through the Night was...
Third?
Tied. Tied for second.
Oh, okay. So tied for second. Yeah. So Imagine was number one?
Yeah, Imagine was his biggest hit.
Okay.
Instant Karma hit the same thing, number three. Imagine hit number three. But Whatever Gets You Through the Night hit number one,
yeah,
and so did Just Like Starting Over. You'd think those and Woman hit number two, but it must be the power of how long it stayed on the charts.
Probably,
and stuff
yeah.
Like
Imagine it's still being played.
Yeah.
So
yeah. That's, yeah.
All right, yeah, 'cause it was the number one song for me. Maybe that was the number one song for me on the charts for the longest time, or something like that.
John Lennon with the Plastic Uno Nuclear Band.
Yeah. Yeah, it doesn't say anything about Elton John there, does it?
Yeah,
it
Elton John,
okay.
Backing vocal.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Which probably sold a lot of the the records.
Well, and I know a lot of people didn't even know that was Elton John backing them up. So
I probably wouldn't have known it either if I hadn't read it somewhere.